Very good morning, dear children. Today we are going to start a new branch of mathematics, algebra. Okay, so this is chapter 10, okay, which is on page number 126. So first is introduction to algebra. Okay, I think you are doing for the first time, okay, algebra. So till now we are dealing only with the numbers, okay? How to add the numbers, how to multiply the numbers, how to divide numbers and subtract the numbers, okay? So we are dealing only with the numbers. Now this algebra, this is also a mathematics. It is a branch of mathematics, okay, where we use letters to represent the numbers, okay? So this is new for you all. Now we are going to represent the number by letters. You know, letters are A, B, C, D, no? Till Z. So here, okay, in this chapter, we are going to add the numbers. We are going to subtract the numbers. You will learn about the constant and the variables here, okay, in algebra. First is, that is very important, you have to understand the constant and variables. See, what is constant? Constant is all the numbers whose value is always same, like 1, its value is always 1, 2, 3, no, like 100, 200, 300, all the numbers are called constant whose value is same. No, the value of 1 will be 1, it won't be 2, no? So the value of 1 is always 1. Similarly, value of 3 is 3. 3 means we can understand this is 3, okay? But variables means whose value is not fixed, whose value changes from time to time. So all the letters, we can't say what is the value of A. We can take A as 1, we can take A as 2, no? So these are the letters, okay? So letters are variables whose value changes. So you just have to keep in mind that all the numbers are constant and all the letters are variables. Now we will start exercise 10.1, okay? So first question is, identify the variables and the constant in the following algebraic statements. So your algebraic statement is given 5 minus 6x, okay? So here you have to find out which are variables and which are constant. So variable, as I have already told you, that letters are variable whose value is not fixed. So here the variable is x, you have to write, okay? X is variable, and constant are all the numbers 5 and 6. So here constant are 5 and 6. Next is 2 plus m. So here variable is m, you have to write your m, and constant is number 2. Okay, so 2 is constant. Next is question number C, 3p plus 10. So variable here, letter is p, so p is variable, and constant we have 3 and 10. So this 3 and 10 are constant and this letter P is variable. Next is, your variable is L, letter is L, and constant is 56. So this is how we can identify variables and constant. Variables means your letters, okay, alphabets, and your constant is all the numbers. Question number 2 is, identify whether the following are variables V or constants. Variable means whose value is not fixed, and constant is whose value is fixed, whose value does not change. So number of minutes in an hour. So you have to identify whether this statement is variable or constant. So number of minutes in 1 hour. We know in 1 hour there is always 60 minutes, no? So this is fixed. 1 hour is always 60 minutes. So this is constant. So 1 hour is 60 minutes and this is fixed, constant, okay? 1 hour is always 60 minutes. Next is number of days in a month. So we know in January there are 31 days, in February there are 28 or 29 days. No, if it is leap year, then it is 29 days, and January, February, March is 31 days. So in month, okay, number of days are not fixed. In some month there are 30 days and in some month there are 31 days. So this is not constant, okay, this is variable. So here I have written some months have 30 days and some have 31 days and February have 28 or 29 days. So this is variable. Okay, actually answer is only variable, right? But this is the reason. In exam you can write only variables, you don't have to give reason. Okay, so now I'm giving so that you can understand it. Okay, why it is variable. Next is number of colors in the rainbow. So we know in rainbow there are violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. 7 colors. Always there are 7 colors. So this is fixed. No, every times in rainbow there are 7 colors. So this is constant. So this is constant. Next is numbers of letters in the English alphabets. So we know there are 26 days. Okay, from A to Z. Okay, there are always 26 alphabet. So this is also constant. So there are 26 letters in an English alphabet. So this is constant C. Now we will start new exercise 10.2. Okay, so identify the rule and find the next term in the following patterns. Also write the rule for the nth term of the pattern. So this nth term is, it can be 10th term, it can be 19th term, it can be 20th term. Okay, so nth term, you have to find the nth term of the pattern. So you have to observe this pattern carefully. Okay, here are two, here are 1 2 3 4, here are 1 2 3 4 5 6, and here are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And here are 10. Okay. So in each step, okay, so 2 is increasing. Okay, 2 is increasing. So here 2 plus 2, 4. Then 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 2, 10. Now next will be 12. Okay, 10 plus 2, 12. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Now we have to make here 12. So here are 12. Okay, the next term will be 12. Now we have to find the nth term also. So nth term means, okay, I've told you that all the alphabets are variable. Okay, it can be 10th term, it can be 12th term. This is first term, second term, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Okay, similarly nth term will be what? So these all are the multiples of 2. See, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8. So the nth term will be 2n. Okay, so if you put your 1, it will be 2. 1s are 2. If you put your 2, 2 2s are 4. If you put your 3, 2 3s are 6. If you put your 4, 2 4s are 8. And if you put your 5, 2 5s are 10. And if you put your 6, 2 6 are 12. So if you put your 7, it will be 2 7s are 14. So another term will be 14. Okay, so this is our nth term. Next is question number B. Here we have only 2. No, 2, and here we have 1, 2, 3, 3 we have, and here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, smiley, you know, this smiley is increasing by 1, okay, only 1 is added, right? 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 1, 5, now next will be 6. So next will be 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we have to find the nth term. Okay, so nth term is, so here it is increasing by 1. So nth term will be n plus 1. Okay, it is increasing by 1. So here it is, if you put here 1, 1 plus 1, 2. If you put here 2, 2 plus 1, 3. If you put here 3, 3 plus 1, 4. So similarly, here this is 6. This is your first, second, third, fourth, fifth term, right? 5 plus 1, 6. And if you have to find the next one, you have to write here 6. 6 plus 1, 7. So this is our nth term. Next question is, write the rules using variables for the following situations. Number A, there are 36 eggs in a tray. So in one tray, there are 36 eggs. How will you write the total number of eggs in terms of the number of trays? So we don't know how many trays are there. But if we take, there are n trays, or you can take x trays also, your wish. You can take any one alphabets, okay, to represent the number of trays. So how many eggs are there in that trays. Okay, so in one tray there are 36 eggs. So here are, in one tray there are 36 eggs. Okay, suppose we will take there are n trays. Okay, there are n trays, we don't know the value of n. No, as I have told you that this is variable, it can be 1, it can be 2, it can be 3, it can be 4. So we have taken there are n trays. So in n trays, how many eggs are there? So in one tray there are 36 trays, and in n tray you have to multiply by n. Okay, so 36 into n is 36 n. So in n trays there are 36 n eggs. Number B is, a cheetah can run 29 meters per second. Means in 1 second, cheetah can cover 29 meters. Express the distance covered by the cheetah in terms of its running time in second. So before this chapter, I have already taught you speed, distance and time, where I have taught you how to find the distance, how to find the speed and how to find the time, right? So here we have to find the speed, okay? So cheetah can cover 36 meters in 1 second. Okay, so you have to write like this: distance covered in 1 second is 36 meters. So if we take time n seconds, okay, so in n seconds, what is the distance covered by cheetah? So in 1 second, if cheetah can cover 36 meters, then in n second, it will cover 36 into n. That is 36 n meters. So cheetah can cover 36 n meters in n second. Now the next question is, the cost of one laddu is rupees 12. So one laddu cost rupees 12. Okay, what will be the cost of n laddu? So if you are buying a laddu, okay, one laddu will cost rupees 12. So you have to give 12 rupees for one laddu. So if you are buying n laddus, then how many, what is the total cost? Okay, how much money you have to give? So cost of one laddu is rupees 12. We have to find cost of n laddus. So 12 will be multiplied by number of laddus. Okay, 12 into n, rupees 12 n. So this is our last question. Okay, so in next class we will start new exercise.